Now the next instrument is Eustonsil snare. Look at this image. This is the image of Eustonsil snare. The snare has stainless steel wire which is usually 3 inches long with a thickness of 20th gauge. Look over here. This is the stainless steel wire and its thickness is nearly about 20th gauge. It is used to snare the lower pole of the tonsil after dissection. The lower pole is crushed on snaring and after crushing, thromboplastin is released and we know that it is a powerful vasoconstriction. Yes, it is used for snare the lower pole of the tonsil after dissection. And the second one is it is minimizing the bleeding because it is release thromboplastin and thromboplastin is vasoconstrictor. Now the next instrument is St. Clair Thompson adenoid curette with guard. So look over here, this is the image of St. Clair Thompson adenoid curette with guard. This instrument is used to curette adenoids by technique known as blind technique. And the procedure is the curette is introduced behind the soft palate, yes, behind the soft palate with the blade facing down. It is held like dagger and the adenoid is curetted from the nasopharyngeal wall. And look over here, this is the cage. It is also called as guard. So what is the use of this guard? The guard is used to prevent slipping of the excised tissue into the throat. So what is the use of St. Clair Thompson adenoid curette with guard? The uses is it is used for adenoidectomy and remember this point, the curette, it curate the adenoids by a technique and it is called as blind technique. Okay, the next instrument is tracheal hook. So look over this image, this is the blind tracheal hook and this is the sharp tracheal hook. What is the uses of tracheal hook? This blind tracheal hook, it is used to retract the thyroid isthmus upward. And this sharp tracheal hook, it is applied to lower border of cricoid cartilage. It is applied to lower border of cricoid cartilage to stabilize the trachea and prevent its movements during the respiration when making the incision in the tracheal wall. So basically, it is stabilize the trachea and prevent movement during the respiration. So we can easily take the tracheal wall incision. So it is used for tracheostomy. So this is about tracheal hook. The next instrument is tracheal dilator. Look over this image. This is tracheal dilator. This tracheal dilator, it is used to keep the tracheal edges open after the incision so that the tracheostomy tube can be easily inserted. So what is the use of tracheal dilator? It is used to insert the tracheostomy tube and it is used to prevent formation of false passage. Now the next instrument is laryngoscope. So look over this image. This is the adult type of laryngoscope and look over this image. This is the laryngoscope for the children. So this is for the adults and this is for the children. So basically there are several models of the laryngoscope. The size of laryngoscope is used to vary with the age of patient. Look at this first image. It looks like U-shaped and it is made up of German silver. It uses a rigid fiber optic light carrier for the illumination and this is the handle. Now what are the uses of laryngoscope? So it is used for examination of the larynx, hypopharynx, cricopharynx and upper esophagus. Second one, it is used for removal of foreign bodies from the above regions. The third one is for biopsy from tumors. The fourth one is for excision of tumors or nodules from the glottis or supraglottis. And it can be used to assess the extent of laryngeal growth before the laryngectomy. So these are some uses of laryngoscope. The next instrument is esophagoscope. Look over this image. This is a long rigid hollow tube, nearly about 40 to 45 cm in length and about 16 to 20 mm in diameter. These are some images of esophagoscope. So what are the uses of esophagoscope? So the diagnostically it is used for malignancy, for foreign body examination. It can be used in cardiospasm, can be used for tracheoesophageal fistula, and it can be used in strictures. Therapeutically, it is used for removal of foreign bodies. It can be used to guide bogies through esophageal structures, can be used for esophageal staining, and it can be used for sclerosing agent injection into esophageal varices. So this is about esophagoscope. Now the next instrument is bronchoscope. So look at this image. This is a hollow rigid tube with beveled end, and this tube is about 40 to 45 centimeter long, and it has vents on the side. Look at this image. These are the vents, and these vents are used for ventilation of the other bronchus. Hence this are differs from the esophagoscope. Yes, in esophagoscope there absence of the vents, but in this scope there are vents are present for the ventilation. Okay, so what are the uses of bronchoscope? First, the diagnostic uses, and in which it can be used for examination of tracheobronchial tree for pathologies like the growth, ulcers, strictures, etc. It can be used for biopsy from the suspicious growth or ulcer. It can be used for bronchial lavage from secretions. Can be used for bronchography. It can be used for autofluorescence and photodynamic diagnosis. Therapeutically, it can be used for foreign body removal. It can be used for tracheobronchial stenting, for aspiration of secretions, and can be used for removal of tumors. So this is about the bronchoscope. And remember that in bronchoscope there are vents are present for the ventilation. The next instrument is Fuller's tracheostomy tube. So look at this diagram. This is the Fuller's tracheostomy tube, and it consists of outer tube. This is outer tube, and this is the inner tube. So what is the uses of Fuller's tracheostomy tube? In inner tube there is a hole in the center, so that patient can still have a chance to breathe from the larynx even when the tube is blocked at its outer end. So remember that patient breathe from the larynx even after the blockage of outer tube. And the second one is it prevent the outer tube from getting blocked by the secretions. The examiner can be asked, what are the disadvantages of the Fuller tracheostomy tube? Then what will you answer? Yes, the disadvantages are the tips of the flanges can injure the tracheal wall. The flanges can break after the long use and present as foreign bodies. Yes, it can be possible. And there is risk of granulation tissue formation. So this is about Fuller's tracheostomy tube. The next instrument is Jackson's tracheostomy tube. In Jackson's tracheostomy tube, look over this image. This is outer tube, this is inner tube, and this is the pilot obturator. So these are the parts of Jackson's tracheostomy tube. What is the uses of the Jackson's tracheostomy tube? Remember that examiner can be asked the what is the use of pilot obturator. So you must know that the obturator is helps in introduction of the tube into the trachea. So because of this, there is a protection from the injury to the posterior wall. So we can say that injury is not caused to the posterior wall due to the pilot obturator. An examiner may ask what is the disadvantages of this tube. Then you must know that because of this, phonation is not possible. The patency of the natural air passage cannot be checked by the blocking of tube. There is a risk of granulation tissue formation, and it is also possible in the Fuller's tracheostomy tube. Look at this. Yes, there is also disadvantage of formation of the granulation tissue. The last instrument is curved suction aid tracheostomy tube. So this is the image of curved suction aid tracheostomy tube. It is like an ordinary curved tube, but it has a suction tube. Look at this. This is the suction tube to suck out the pharyngeal secretion collected above the cuff. So what is it used? Is that it is used to suck out the pharyngeal secretion. That's why second use is that it prevents the aspiration into the trachea. So this is all most important instrument for your ENT practicals. Thank you for watching this video.